Hey guys, so I know often I talk about doing stretches at work, but I haven't actually shown you one that you can literally do in the comfort of your own chair in case you happen to be struggling to find an excuse to get up and do them. So I'm going to take you through some stretches that are going to open up the chest, ease the neck, and release the hips while you are at your desk in your chair. So we're going to start from the top down. First, I want you to flex that right hand. Keep the shoulder back, take your left ear to your left shoulder, left hand over the top of the head. You're going to breathe in, and as you breathe out, let everything drop down, especially that shoulder in there. We don't want to hold neck stretches for much longer than 5 to 10 seconds, as they need to hold the integrity of that neck structure. And again, breathing in, we're going to swap arms. Left hand flexes down, right ear to right shoulder, right hand over the top of the head, breathe in. And breathe out, relax. Then go back to the other side, breathe in. Flex the right hand again, this time left ear to left shoulder, but look to the left underarm. Hand comes to the back corner of the head, breathe in. And as you breathe out, let everything relax. We're gonna move to the other side, breathe in. Flex the left hand, take the right ear to the right shoulder, look to the right underarm, right hand to the back corner of the head, breathe in, and breathe out, let everything relax. And breathing in again. From here, we're going to interlock the fingers behind the back, looks like this. We're going to squeeze the shoulder blades together. Now, if you don't have enough reach to get your hands behind your back, what you can do is grab a strap or your belt, or a jacket, or anything that is going to extend that reach. You're gonna squeeze the shoulder blades together. We're then gonna forward fold, but I want you to make sure that you're rolling your belly and your chest onto your thighs before you travel over the legs and the arms lift up. You're trying to reach those thumbs, or the pinkies, sorry, down to the floor. And we're gonna breathe in, slowly lift up. We're then going to take the hands to the right side of the body, so to the right, and as you breathe out, this is what it looks like from the side. You're going to squeeze those shoulder blades together and draw the shoulders down away from the ears. Again, if you have a strap, you're pulling in like so. You're then going to stretch the arms out and take them to the other side. Looks like this. Squeeze the elbows together, draw the belly and the ribs in, draw the shoulders down. Again, if you have a strap, it will look like this. We again stretch the arms back, roll the belly and chest to the thighs, and arms travel over the head again one more time. And we breathe in, slowly lift up. Remember to always think about breathing through each stretch. You'll get a lot more out of it. Next, we're going to take the right hand onto the seat, left arm reaches up, and we're going to lean to that right side. Push that foot down, you can also use this arm as stability. We're then going to turn the torso down towards the floor and still reaching the arm out. And then we're going to place the hand on the chair, and you're going to pull yourself around even more, so levering off your thigh. You can even take your right hand and grab the back of your chair and turn, but make sure you're turning around and down, not up and over, but around and down. And then breathe in and come forward. We're going to do the other side. So left hand on the chair, right arm reaches up, turn the pinky forward and lean to that left side. We then turn the torso towards the floor, still reaching the hands out. And we bring the right hand to the chair and leverage off that arm to turn the torso around and down. Remember, you can grab the back of the chair if you want to. And breathing in, turn forward and release. We're now going to fold forward towards the floor again. Whether you can reach the floor or not, you'll still be able to do this one. So if you can't reach the floor, you're going to grab your calf with the opposite hand and turn to the right. And you're going to open up the shoulder and reach up towards the sky. If you can touch the floor, you can reach the hand down to the middle, or if you want to go further, to the outside of the foot, and again, reach up and open up towards the sky. Or in your case, if you're inside the ceiling. down wherever you are, come back up. Reset, take a deep breath in, and we go down again. So you can go hand to the middle, hand to the outside, or to the calf, turn out, and reach up towards the ceiling. And breathe out, bring the arm down, and slowly lift up. Good. We're now going to move into the hips, which is a terrible one for a lot of people. So since we're sitting this way, we're going to focus on the hip flexors first and remove that ankle. You're going to shuffle to one edge of the seat. So one ass cheek is off the seat, okay? You're then going to take your foot back as far as you can so it reaches back and you squeeze your bum. So if I do this on this side so you can see. So I'm off my chair, I've reached the foot right back, tuck the toe under, and what I'm focusing on is squeezing the bum and drawing the belly in. So that hip, that bend here in the hip is going to be gone. We're trying to squeeze at the bum, draw the belly in to release it. Literally push the foot into the floor, squeeze the bum, draw the belly in. If you want to take it further in your seat, you can reach the same arm up, lean to the side. So in your case, if you're sitting forward in your chair, let's reach up, lean to the side. If you want more, you can then turn down. It's up to you how much you want, but this is going to stretch that chain. Open up and release. Let's do the other side. So we shuffle to the other side of the chair. Ass cheek hangs off. Tuck the back toe under. I'll show you on this side. Tuck the back toe under. Squeeze the bum. Draw the belly in. Hold here. If you want to take it further in that position, you reach the same arm up and lean over the chair. Be mindful that you don't lift in the hip, that you're still dropping down into that leg. And then turn the torso towards the chair. Remember, whatever you did on one side, do the same on the other. And breathe in, open up, and release. We're now going to go into the glutes to finish. So I want you to lean back right in your chair. You're going to lift your foot up and place it right here. A lot of you would sit like this. So the starting point is easy. Where it gets difficult is you're going to sit up nice and tall, and we're going to watch this knee is probably going to lift. You're going to hold the chair for leverage, and you're going to push that right knee down and sit forward. Remember, hooking the belly button, pulling you forward. If you find that easy and you don't need that leverage, you can bring your hands here. You're trying to square your leg off with that level. Rather than here, we're trying to get it here. Remember, you can leverage if you need to. Leaning forward. If this is enough for you, then stay here. But if you want to go further, you can lean forward, right hand stays here, and reach down to the ground. So it gives you a marker for how far forward you're folding. If that's easy, you can then fold right over the leg. And remember to breathe. And then when you're done, wherever you are, breathing in, slowly lifting up and releasing. Again, lean back in the seat. Bring the ankle on top, not right on the tip of the knee, but just above. We're going to sit up tall now. You can leverage the chair and push down that leg. If you find that you can't even reach that or you can't get in there, place the left hand on the inside and push that down. Sitting up tall, reaching forward with the chest. You can place both hands on if you did so on the other side. You can reach one hand down if you did so on the other side. And then watching that knee doesn't fold up, you can reach both hands forward if you did on the other side. And when you're done, breathing in, slowly lifting up, stretch the legs out. And I'm sure you can stand up for a few minutes and walk around. And if you can, I highly recommend it, because sitting down for too long is not good for you. When you do these stretches, try to keep it to 15 to 30 seconds. My suggestion, go for 15 seconds. Literally count them out. It'll be like a nice meditation.